from her place to the tube station. And she had a phone number. And she said,
okay, good evening, everybody. Thank you for coming. This public meeting is for the Community Development Committee to inform the public meeting. It's for the Community Development Committee to inform the public of the proposed zoning bylaw amendment for the lands legally described as block 1, 2, 3, and 5 of 39M 796, and referred to as Benson Court lands. The purpose of the proposed rezoning is to allow for hotel and motel as permitted uses on the subject lands. Do we have any declarations of interest from the committee members? Seeing none, I'll turn it over to the clerk for the explanation of the statutory notice procedures.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. I can confirm that notice has been given in accordance with Section 34, Subsection 13 of the Planning Act. All persons and agencies who are entitled to receive notice by first-class mail and advertised in the local newspaper. Notification details are fully contained within the planner's report and within file number ZB01-2020.
Thank you. Staff reports, Sonia Tam.
Thank you, Deputy Mayor. So to reiterate, the purpose of tonight's meeting is essentially to present to members of the public as well as the Community Development Committee on a rezoning proposal that's been put forward for the Benson Court lands. And these lands are located on the north side of Croft Street, west of Templeton Road. They have a lot area of approximately 6.8 hectares, and they are designated service employment under the Portville official plan and zone general employment with a site-specific exception 43 under the current zoning bylaw. So to give a bit of background on the Benson Court subdivision lands, in 2003, the municipality entered into a subdivision agreement with the owner of the lands, and that resulted in the creation of the Benson Court lands as shown on the slide above. So at the time, those lands were designated under the official plan as light industrial and zoned industrial park, with an exception that would specifically allow for a number of uses, including a motor vehicle dealership. So in June of that year, a site plan agreement was entered into with the owner and the municipality, and that would result in what is now the Hyundai Motor Vehicle Dealership. Later in 2015, the owner came back to the municipality and requested what's called part lot control. So three new lots were created on the eastern portion of the Benson Court lands. And in September of that year, the owner came back for a site plan agreement for the Volkswagen dealership. So you'll see on this slide essentially what the lands look like today. So you have the two dealerships located on the northern portions of the lands. There's also a telecommunication tower that's been in existence even prior to the 2003 subdivision agreement. And then you'll also see that the lands are bounded to the north by Highway 401 and to the east, that is Hamilton Township. So in terms of surrounding uses to the east and the north, those are primarily agricultural uses. And then to the west and the south, those are more employment uses. I'd like to note that as part of what we've considered the subject lands tonight, you'll see that the western portion shows what is the stormwater management pond. It's not included in the subject lands. However, it was originally part of the Benson Court lands. That pond has now been acquired by the municipality, so it is not subject to tonight's application for rezoning. So the proposal that has been put forward by Clark Consulting Services has been a request to rezone the subject lands to allow for a hotel and a motel use. So currently the lands are zoned general employment with a site-specific exception. Under the general employment zone, a hotel and motel are not considered permitted uses. So that is why the applicant is here today asking for those uses to be added. I'd like to emphasize at this time that this is not a proposal to construct a hotel or motel. This is simply an application to deal with the matter of use. If and when a hotel or motel does come in prior to construction, the developer will have to enter into a site plan agreement with the municipality. So the next couple slides are going to be about the land use policy. I'm going to try and get through this pretty quickly. I'm going to start off with provincial policy and then make my way down to municipal land use policies. So from a provincial perspective, you have two documents, the provincial policy statement as well as the growth plan. Both documents designate the subject lands to be within what's called the urban settlement area. And in the settlement area, that's where growth and development is to be targeted, and specifically economic development. So a hotel and motel are forms of diversification to the local economy. So staff are of the opinion that in terms of the uses that have been proposed, those are in compliance with provincial policy. These documents also speak to sufficient connections to municipal infrastructure. As part of the 2003 subdivision agreement, a stormwater management brief had been prepared at that time. So as part of this current submission, the applicable agencies, Works and Engineering, the Ministry of Transportation, as well as the Conservation Authority, they've all had a look at that document. They have no issues with the additions of the hotel or motel use, but as if and when a hotel or motel do come in, they will be part of the review process to ensure that there'll be sufficient connections to municipal services, as well as sufficient quality and quantity control when it comes to stormwater management. Now, in Port Hope, we have two official plans that provide the framework for how land use is envisioned for the municipality. First, you have the upper tier, the county official plan. And the county official plan designates the subject lands to be within the urban area. The county plan, in terms of specific land use designations, defers to the lower tier. So Port Hope's official plan to speak specifically to where these individual land use designations should be directed. So in the Port Hope official plan, it speaks to the subject lands as being designated as service employment. So if you remember earlier, I had indicated that in 2003, the lands in question were designated light industrial. With the changes in the official plan, that is equivalent to what's known as general employment zones, land use designations. But in the last official plan comprehensive review, the owner actually came to the municipality and requested that be changed from general employment to the service employment designation. And so that is why the lands are designated as they are today. And in terms of what the official plan says about permitted uses. A hotel and motel are permitted, so that's why staff are of the opinion that this proposal meets the official plan policies. Now, finally making our way down to the zoning bylaw. So as I indicated earlier, the zoning for this property is general employment with a site-specific exception 43. And in this zone, the general employment zone, a hotel and motel are not permitted as of right. That's why the applicant has come in for the zoning request. And specifically, the applicant has come in to request an addition to of uses, so adding the hotel and motel use to the current zone. This is a breakdown of what the applicant has put forward and what staff have put forward. Fundamentally, staff don't have any issues with the hotel and motel zone or uses being added to the zoning, to the subject lands. Where there is a difference in opinion is what the resulting zone should be. So where staff come from is that our opinion is that there should be a comprehensive look at what the resulting zone should end up being. The official plan, its purpose is to essentially provide a framework for land use planning in a municipality. A zoning bylaw implements those policies. Currently, the Port Hope official plan designates the lands to be service employment, but our zoning zones the lands to be general employment. So we would like there to be an alignment in those two policy documents. So that's why staff would suggest that instead of maintaining the site-specific general employment zone, to rezone the lands actually be service employment zone. And this would do two things. One, the service employment zone actually allows, as of right, the hotel and motel use, so that would satisfy the applicant's request. And then two, it would also align the two policy documents, the official plan and the zoning bylaw. I'd also like to say that currently this is a site-specific proposal. Now, from time to time, the municipality undergoes a statutory comprehensive zoning bylaw review. If, let's say, there was to be a review today, staff would still be recommending that the subject lands be rezoned to a service employment zone. So that is something to be considered. So this is basically the end of my presentation. In summary, staff don't have any fundamental issues with the hotel and motel use. It's just that there's a difference in opinion in what the resulting zone should be. Commenting agencies have indicated they don't have any objections to the proposed zoning bylaw amendment. So that's why there are two draft zoning considerations for you all to have a look at and consider. So from here, in terms of next steps, staff anticipate that there'll be a report that goes to committee of the whole on March the 3rd, and then subsequently a draft or a bylaw to the meeting of March the 17th. Thank you.
Correspondence?
Thank you, Mr. Chair. I can advise that notification has been given in accordance with the provisions of the Planning Act, as outlined in the circulation schedule of the planner's report on January 22nd. The zoning bylaw amendment application was circulated to the applicable internal departments and external agencies. A combined notice of a complete application and notice of the public meeting for the rezoning was given to all assessed persons within 120 meters of the subject lands. It was mailed on January 28, 2020. Notice was placed in the Northumberland News on January 23, 2020, and on the municipal website, porthope.ca. Circulation responses have been received from a variety of internal agencies, internal and external agencies, and were included in the planner's report.
Thank you. Thank you. Would the applicant or agent care to respond?
Thank you, Mr. Chairman, members of the committee, members of the public. My name is Bob Clark. I'm the planner, acting as agent for the owner of the property. We have had the opportunity to review the staff report and deem it to be very complete and thorough. We are of the opinion that this is, as your staff have indicated, a suitable site for a hotel and motel use, and we are content with either option. I do appreciate the fact that your staff did review the history and explained that when this was originally zoned, it was shown in conformity with the official plan, with the exceptions established for the auto dealerships. And the change in the official plan would also, in our opinion, it would be reasonable to change the zone type, but we do make we do note that there would still have to be additional uses in order to make it reflect the permitted uses which are on the site today as well. I'm certainly available to answer any questions that anyone may have.
Thank you. Council, any questions? See, and then you, Mr. Clark, you can probably sit down for a second. Submissions from members of the public. If a person or public body would otherwise have an ability to appeal the decision of the municipality of Port Hope to the local planning tribunal, but the person or public body does not make oral submission at a public meeting or make written submissions to the municipality of Port Hope before the proposed bylaw is passed, the person or public body is not entitled to appeal the decision. And if a person or public body does not make oral submission at a public meeting or make written submission to the municipality of Port Hope before the proposed bylaw is passed, the person or public body may not be added as a party to the hearing of an appeal before the tribunal. There are reasonable grounds to add the person or public body as a party. All interested parties who wish to make oral submission this evening should approach the microphone, state your name and address for our records, please. So if there's anybody that would like to step up to the mic.
Good evening, my name is Claudia Bunnycourt and I live on Vernon Boulevard, which is the street immediately behind the subject lands. The lands in question are on the street immediately behind Vernon Boulevard, a family neighborhood with many children. As I'm sure you're all aware, the streets in the surrounding area, Croft, Hamilton, Rose Glen, Vernon, do not have any sidewalks. And many people in the neighborhood walk, jog, walk their pets in the area and have to walk onto the street. And Croft Street is part of the circuit for many. The present zoning, as Sonia said, EMP1, does not provide for a hotel-motel. A hotel-motel on the subject lands would result in a significant increase in traffic along Croft, Rose Glen, Telephone, and Hamilton. And the resulting noise for those on Vernon Boulevard, which backs onto Croft, will mean noise 24/7, 365, for arrival, drive out for meals, drive back, departure. So, we don't know, at least I don't know, what size hotel may be proposed down the road, but if it's an 80-room hotel, similar to what the Hampton Inn is going to be over the west side of town, and at least four trips a day, that would mean an additional 300 vehicle trips on the surrounding streets a day. And if they went out more than once, it would be an additional 500 vehicle trips a day. And this likely wouldn't be just car traffic. truckers could stay at a proposed hotel motel, and there'd be increased truck traffic on Croft, Telephone, Hamilton, and Rose Glen. There's already more than enough truck traffic on Croft Street, what with Henderson's trucks going in and out of their yard all day and all night, and as well, Hamilton and Croft are the haul route for the low-level waste. Further, across Croft Street from the subject lands, there's a field with a path that leads directly into a park that fronts on Peacock. So with an increase in traffic, there would certainly be a decrease in safety for the children in the park. Also, with proposed increase in traffic coming from the 401 via Rose Glen around the curve by McDonald's, a lot of traffic already has difficulty taking that curve way too fast. And even though a proposed four-way traffic light is set for the intersection of Rose Glen and Croft, a lot of people who aren't from the area miss Croft Street completely and are then in front of the park with the baseball diamonds, the park equipment, and the new proposed splash pad. And immediately after that, there's a daycare and school. So, definitely an increased safety risk for our children. We do not need more traffic and the resulting noise on Croft. The businesses on Croft used to be all relatively quiet until Henderson's with their construction yard and trucks and banging. And Henderson's has removed half the depth of the berm behind the houses on Burnham that was put there when the houses were built and we were told was for sound absorption and privacy. So already, all the noise from Croft Street is already increased. A quick search of Google resulted in at least 18 motels and hotels in Port Hope and Coburg, and that doesn't include any Airbnbs. And some of these locations, that shall remain nameless, have a very questionable reputation and clientele, and we certainly wouldn't want something like that on the street immediately behind a residential neighborhood. We don't want to take away from the economic growth and development or the potential revenues for the town or job opportunities. But if someone does want to build a hotel motel, it should be in an area that's already zoned appropriately, definitely not on the street behind a residential neighborhood with families and children and near parks and schools. And accordingly, in my opinion, there should not be a rezoning to EMP2 or an exception under EMP1. I believe, Sonia, a number of residents on Burnham are also sending you emails to the same effect. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you for your submission. It has been noted and recorded. Would anybody else like to speak to this subject? Seeing none, recommended action that the committee receive this report for information and direct staff to prepare a follow-up report once all outstanding matters, including any items brought forward at the public meeting, are addressed. May I have a mover and a seconder, please?
Moved by Councilor Meadows, seconded by the Mayor.
All those in favor? Thank you. And with that, we are adjourned.